Hi viewers, this topic is coming in your module 5 of safety in petroleum and petrochemical industries. This topic is liquefied petroleum gas installations and this is compliant to OISD 144, Oil Industry Safety Directorate or OISD. Publications are prepared for use in the oil and gas industry under Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. As we have told earlier, LPG is a mixture of light hydrocarbons, primarily propane and butane, which are derived from petroleum and which is gaseous at ambient temperature and atmospheric pressure. This is liquefied at ambient temperature with the application of moderate pressure. LPG, due to its inherent properties, are susceptible to fire, explosion, and other hazards. Such hazards have an impact on property, equipment, plant personnel, and public. Therefore, LPG handling, bottling, distribution are the major challenges due to its inherent properties. Major incidents, that is fires, explosion in LPG facilities, depict the need for design, procedures, maintenance, firefighting, and safety aspects in LPG handling. Firstly, about the location of LPG installation. While selecting the suitability of any site for the location of LPG installation, we have to consider the following aspects: location of residential quarters, industries, railways, road, waterway, overhead power lines, and places of public assemblies. Advocate availability of water from any reliable source, that means water should be available throughout the year, or there should be an alternate arrangement of water. Topographical nature of the site, that means any physical characteristics of the land area selected for the LPG installation, that should be with reference to its effect on accidental release of LPG. Availability of space for future extension of LPG facilities, if any, shall comply with the safety norms. The meteorological data, the atmospheric characteristics, or the data related to the atmosphere, these should be considered while selecting the location for LPG installation. That include wind direction, velocity, high flood level, temperatures, and all. Next, about the storage and handling of bulk LPG. There should be strict compliance with respect to selection, deployment of proper skill manpower for effective operation and maintenance. Safe practices and provisions applying to unloading of bulk LPG and storage of bulk LPG at installations. Handling means the loading, unloading, and transportation of bulk LPG. First of all, we'll see about the bulk handling for movement of bulk LPG by road, because we know that the bulk LPG is moved by road, by rail, as well as by sea. By road, we'll see first of all, the tank trucks are used for movement of bulk LPG by road. The tank trucks are designed, constructed, and tested in accordance with the static and mobile pressure vessel rules 1981 and the OISD standard 159. LPG storage facilities, confinement or grading. Dike wall shall be provided around all the sides of storage vessel with concrete flooring of the ground under the vessel and extending up to minimum distance of D by 2, that is diameter by 2, or 5 meters, whichever is higher, or at least 5 meters from the edge of storage vessel. Dike wall height shall be minimum 30 centimeters but shall not exceed 60 centimeters. Grading of the ground underneath should be leveled and directed to an area connected with the water seal away from the storage vessel. Piping. Only piping associated with the storage vessels shall be located within the storage areas or between the storage area and the manifold system. Surface drainage. In order to prevent the escape of spillage into the main drainage system, surface water from the storage area and from the manifold area shall be directed to the main drainage through a water seal to avoid the spread of LPG. Grouping. The vessels shall be arranged into groups, each having a maximum of 6 vessels. There shall be minimum spacing between adjacent vessels. Each group shall be separated by a road on all the 4 sides for easy access and emergency handling. For example, spheres and bullets shall be treated as separate groups with minimum 30 m distance between 2 groups. The following safety precaution should be taken while transferring LPG to or from the tank trucks. No source of ignition must be allowed in the area where the product transfer operations are carried out. Fire extinguishers shall be placed near the tank trucks during the transfer operations. First operation after positioning the truck should be to provide proper earthing. Hoses shall be handled with care and inspected periodically as per OISD standard 135. While disconnecting the hoses, its connections shall be loosened only slightly at first to allow the release of trapped pressure. Do not expose hands, face or clothing to liquid LPG. Always use personal protective equipment while making or breaking the connections to avoid cold burn, because we have told a property of LPG that it causes cold burn or frostbite. Master switch shall be put off immediately after parking the truck in position. No electrical switch on the truck shall be turned on or off during the transfer operation. No repairs shall be made on the truck loading area. Make sure that there are wheel chokes. Wheel chokes means they are the materials which are used to prevent the movement of vehicles, and they are kept very near to the wheels. New tank trucks or vessels, or vessels received after repair, shall be purged. Purging is done along with the nitrogen gas. Venting and purging of LPG during the transfer operation shall not be carried out in open atmosphere. It shall be piped to a suitable flare system. Flare system will collect all the components coming out after venting or purging operation. Procedures for operation by loading. The first thing is we have to check for the following in a tank truck: provision for safety valve, level gauges, excess flow check and control valve on liquid and vapor lines, pressure gauges, temperature gauge on the vessel or bullet. The thing is that all the parameters should be checked thoroughly by using the gauges or meters. Fire screen between the cabin and vessel is provided. Fire extinguishers, DCP fire extinguishers, 10 kilograms, 2 numbers should be provided. Fitting of spark arresters of approved quality. No leakage in the exhaust silencer pipe exits. Manufacturer's nameplate with date of testing to be fitted on the vessel. Valid explosive license and RTO certificate is available. Make sure. Approved drawings of the vessel, earthing cable, earthing or bonding point, these all are available. Bonding between the vessel and flanges should be satisfactory. Third party inspection, test certificates for the vessel and fittings are available. Liquid or vapor line valves are in good condition. After doing all the procedures for the tank truck, next processes to move the truck to the loading bay, weigh bridge and record the weight of empty tank truck. So So the weight of the empty tank truck is determined. Place the truck on the loading bay and place chalk blocks at front and rear wheel. Placing of the chalk block will help to prevent the movement of the trucks. Keep the truck in neutral mode with hand brakes on. Stop the engine. Switch off all the electrical equipment. All persons should leave the driver's cabin. Make earthing connections of the vehicle at specified point to a fixed grounding system. Connect the liquid and vapor lines suitably with the loading point. Crack open the valve on the loading and vapor return lines. Inspect hoses and connections for leakage. Loading should start only when the system is leak-free. So make sure there is no leak. Start the loading pump. The quantity loaded into the truck can be determined by liquid level, weighment, porosity displacement meter, mass flow meter. The liquid level may be determined by fixed liquid level gauge. Where weigh bridge is used, it is necessary to determine the density of the product being loaded to avoid excess filling in terms of volume. Weigh bridge shall be periodically calibrated and stamped by weights and measures authorities. When the filling operation is in progress, the pressure within the tank truck vessel shall be observed to ensure that it does not approach the start to discharge pressure of the relief valve. Filling rate may be regulated as required. The couplings may then be removed and plugs or caps replaced on the tank truck valve. Recheck the tightness with soap solution. The procedures for unloading operation. The liquid line and vapor line of the tank truck shall be connected to the respective hoses fixed to the unloading point. Next, we have to check for any leakages. Test the connections for the leak by slightly opening the valve for pressurizing. When satisfied, the valve on the tank truck and receiving vessel shall be opened. Start the LPG compressor. Vapors will be sucked from the receiving vessel and will be discharged into the vapor space of the tank truck vessel, creating a pressure differential, thereby pushing the liquid from the tank truck vessel to the receiving vessel. Care should be exercised to see that the pressure created within the delivering vessel does not reach or exceed the set pressure of the relief valve. An authorized person of the company shall supervise the transfer operation and respond immediately in the event of an emergency. Bulk handling of LPG or movement by sea. Transportation of LPG in bulk by tankers may be carried out under fully pressurized, semi-pressurized or fully refrigerated at atmospheric pressure conditions. Cargo carriers are used for transportation by sea. The design and construction of cargo carriers are carried out according to the International Maritime Organization GAS code. Tanker facilities. The cargo handling equipment in a tanker usually comprises of cargo pumps, compressors, condensers, heat exchangers, vaporizers, and cargo heaters. Check that all these devices are in the working condition. The safety devices used are at least two safety valves in each cargo tank, high and low level alarms, overfill alarm. The following facilities on transfer piping between terminal and shore tanks should be provided. Relief valve on liquid line to search vessel with an audible alarm system connected to safe venting system. Physical protection against impact to vent and drain pipes. Protection of pipeline against corrosion, particularly when the pipeline passes under public roadway, which is likely to be waterlogged. The terminal facilities. Transfer of LPG from ship to terminal and vice versa is according to OCIMF guidelines of the loading arms. OCIMF means Oil Companies International Marine Forum guidelines. Unloading operations. It is essential that the ship and the terminal operators are familiar with the basic characteristics of each other's facilities, are aware of the precise division of responsibilities, and they are able to communicate effectively during the time they are together involved in the joint operation of cargo handling. Communication. Reliable and effective communication are the prerequisites of safe and efficient cargo operation. Storage of bulk LPG. The following are the precautions for storage of LPG in bulk. Liquid level in the vessel shall not exceed the permissible limits. Filling shall not exceed safe permissible filling ratio. Vessel shall be inspected daily for any LPG leakage and corrective action should be taken. All the gauges or measuring devices like high level alarm, measuring gauges, pressure gauges, temperature gauges should be kept in operating condition at all the time and it should be checked daily. So by this video lecture, I hope you are familiar with storage and handling of bulk LPG. Strictly follow the OISD standard 144. Thank you.